Are you happy with yourself now, Jake? By the way, I'm sorry if this sounds rushed. It's because it is. I finished this about an hour and 15 minutes ago. I'm Nathan, I should start with that. I'm Nathan Cole. I'm a freshman, which is very nice because I don't have to deal with sophomore crap yet. And I go to Elkhorn High School. So, nothing much. I don't really have a title for this, so let's just go. I've spent years focusing on my style, changing and mending, fixing and bending, and now I can think of it and smile. The lead skimmed across the sheet of blank printer paper, of which I still used later, and I sketched a soldier with guns inside of a fleet. After some time, I became a little better. The time I took shrunk, and my pencil went thunk onto the table, and half the time, as I saw a love letter. But after some time, I found something new, the scratch of pencil no longer there, the ink flowing through the air, the technology side of my art let me soar, and I flew. The pressure of the pen touched the screen, added a thicker line to bold the edges of the barrel of twine, and all of this happened by the time I was 15. I've seen other sketches and found inspiration. I found my lead, and I kept out the weeds from the thoughts in my head that led me to desperation. But that's my problem. I've seen my improvement, but I still think it's not good. I don't feel the improvement, but I know it's there when I look back. I still don't think I'm better. I still think I'm the little kid with Crayola markers scribbling in a messy collage that causes my art to look more like a collage than actual people, and the point I make doesn't get through. The weeds burrow inside of my mind, the resilience so strong to my pestering of stop it and get out of my heads, and I go to the one place I found my hope. That lead, I head back over to my model and I found all sorts of more and better art. You're not good enough to make this. What are you, perfection? Stop whining. Someone's gotta be at the bottom for someone else to be at the top. They yell louder and shout in my ear. I sometimes hear them so clearly I need to check my back just to make sure no one is there. I try and find something to stuff them out. I look to the internet again and I find myself digging into a rabbit hole of procrastination, looking for something funny to drown my sorrows. And as the music stops and the video ends, I feel that fear of failing rushing in back into me. And then I think of one little phrase that I have needed for the rest of my life. One little line. You can't control others or the past. Focus on what you can control, you and what you can do and your future. So I pick up the pen and I look at something around me to put on the paper, and such as something looking over my shoulder and twisting the light bulb into the socket that was already there, I think of it. And it's me and what I've done. And for once, I put myself first and my hand flows across the screen as if I've had the secret idea in my head the entire time and I needed my worst enemy to flip the switch, because sometimes the best things come from the lowest spots. And I climb my way to the top as the lower becomes the higher and the higher lower over the piles of others trying to get a small foothold. And I don't stop until I climb the pole all the way until I can't climb further. And I look around and the people I once looked up to are right beside me. Yeah.